Just getting everything set up here. How you guys doing? Happy today. Happy day 257. Happy 2015. Celebrating all the last bits of it. What's up, Big Mac? Man, I'm great. Yeah. I got this new video coming out. There's a new trailer coming out for the game. I'll show that at the end of the stream, I'm thinking. And yeah, things are going great. Oh no, is the chat reloading? Sorry, Twitch is crazy today. I don't know what's going on. But did I start this? Did I start recording the stream? Sorry, I'm a mess today. Yeah, I did. All right, cool. Okay, back to the data-driven world. So, the past like few days I've been working on this new boss fight at the very beginning of the game, and that's all really turned out really awesome. Later on this week, I'm gonna be working on getting Jib in here too. So Jib. So yeah, Jib's actually gonna get scared during any kind of boss fight. Jib's gonna get scared, do some more interesting stuff. So it'll be, yeah, Jib will kind of have a second mode. He'll have boss mode. What's up, Tom? Right, so today's goal is to go way more data-driven. If you'll notice, I've changed my whole Xcode workflow, and it's really helped. So when somebody wants to yeah, if you want to, if anybody asks about that, I'll start sharing. But for now, I'm just going to start making the game a little more data driven. There's this th something I've been wanting to change for a minute, and that is to do better these collisions, these shorthand bits of data here are not descriptive enough. Really? That's weird. What's up, PMC? Welcome, welcome, you guys. I mean, I hope you're having a great day. Okay, let's get to a boss that has, like here, this is a good example. What's up, Lime Studios? Like the attack component, for example, this would be attack type melee. Mask friend. Yeah, there is, huh? Yeah, dude, Twitch. Damn. Well, okay, well, maybe this might just turn out to be a YouTube video then for people. So anyways, yeah, I'm gonna keep on making this data driven. Hopefully Twitch improves today. There's something weird going on. Even their web servers are going crazy, so I'm gonna get all these. Are you still here? Hitbox, exactly. Should name it that. All right, well, you can still hear, huh? All right, yay. Can you hear this? What I'm doing now is I'm going and I'm gonna look at the some of these components. for example, attack component and see how it's parsed. This is the shorthand parsing. It works now. Yeah, you got greenlit. Yeah, that's awesome. So great, dude. Yeah. So that first word's melee, mask, damage. Damage. Next word is delay, then duration. This would be hitbox. But I think there's two different, yeah, there's attack box, horizontal and vertical. Froze again. It's just black for you. Call this one collision H, collision V. What are the next things here? Shake duration, shake strength. There. That's how these can be reworked. It's back? Oh, wow. Cool. All right. Yay. Oh, maybe Twitch is fixing it. Yeah. All right. So collision. Let's do collision now. Oops. What I'm making today, data-driven today, is the profiles for enemies, entities, you know, bosses, everything that's an entity. I want it to be able to be a lot clearer. So before I had all of this stuff on one line. Like for anything that has an attack component, it would have the word melee and then friend and then 0.5 and like all these things packed into one line. And I never ever knew what any of them were. It was a bad move making that all so cryptic. So I'm making these a lot clearer. I'm just making it so when all these entities have their data much, much clearer. So that's today's goal. Yeah, average 20, that's probably wrong. Lol. Likewise, move pathfinding. Okay, collision component, next thing, this thing, the first word is category and then mask. It's radio day. Radio. Hey, everybody. Looks like we're having a nice, crisp fall day here. We're going to have some lightning storms later this week and rain and lots of thunder. And you better get on your rain boots. It's going to be rainy. That was my take on doing the weather. I'm pretty good. I should get hired as a radio host for sure. So like this guy would be category foe, and then mask. Mask would be. Has it? It's been raining. Good for you guys. Yes. Yeah. Nice. Oh, right. Category foe. Default mask is shop friend, shop top hat, shop neutral. Oh, you got it solved. Open and pop up player. Wow. Nice, J2. All right, if anybody's still having video problems, try that. Try opening in the pop-out player. There we go. Okay, we got mask. Next up. Yeah, oh, right on. Wow, sweet. Okay, well, those hiccups aside, that sounds great. Let's keep up with this non-hiccupy stream. Hmm? Category mass, size, damage, flags. Size. I like the word size instead of collision here. So let's do size H, size V. This could, of course, be three-dimensional if we want. Yeah, did it work? Hopefully. Size damage, default 0.5. That should probably be negative 0.5. Or like that. Oh, really? Damn. Yeah, PMC. Yeah, that's pretty crazy, right? Activision Blizzard bought King for $6 billion. Oh, right on. Flags. Flags is zero. There, we got a full collision. That's what a collision is going to now look like. What's great about doing this data oriented is not only can I do enemies this way, but even little entities like a rock or a tree or whatever can be defined with data and then easily loaded without any code. Why are the sizes uneven? For what? In the biggest accidental in-app purchase. No refunds. You bought King. You can't unbuy King. You own it forever now. Sorry, Activision Blizzard. Oh, whoa. Pressing the wrong key here. Health component. This thing has HP, max HP. So the first thing is your number of hit points. Second thing is invincible duration and then invincible blinks. That's a really easy one. And invincible duration defaults to 0.5. Evolves to two there? It's just two? Ah, okay. The size of the enemy. Why are the sizes uneven? Oh, for this? This is his attack box. Yeah, so his horizontal attack. This is for the dropped boss guy. He only attacks to horizontally. So that's why he has a horizontal attack box, but no vertical attack box. And if you're talking about this one, this is just the size of his collision box. It's just 31 pixels wide, 27 pixels high, and that worked out to be the right feeling for that boss. Yeah, that's just 31 wide by 27 tall. Yeah, it's true. I saw that too. The king's been... It was a risky buy, that's for sure. Okay, next move component. Here's where we're gonna move pathfinding into there. This is, I believe, move mask. Yeah, this is the move mask. And this is the speed. And this is the, this is like the speed up time. Let's figure that out. Yeah, mask speed, XL duration and decel duration. That's right. Oh, yeah, no. This doesn't have anything to do with how the sprite looks. The collision boxes are only for the actual collision, and I just made them that way because that's what felt right. Yeah. So that's the duration of time it takes to accelerate, and here's how long it takes to decelerate. Even though decel duration doesn't work yet, but there, that is a complete move component. Knockback. Okay, all right. Knockback, yeah. Collision should have a knockback. You should, so yeah. Input component. Input should be like input. We'll do allow. This whole attack tile sync offset. We'll make this underneath attack. Actually, I need to note this used to be attack tile sync offset. There's a couple other things I should have noted before I started this, but oh well. Explosion size. This also should be a part of health component. This is something when an entity dies. Boss one. That might be okay. No, there's not, J2. That was something I did. I had this that way for a long time. And then I realized it was so much work to keep on specifying how many frames every animation was when it's really easy to detect at runtime how many frames there are in animation. So I took out that horrible, what would you call that? It's just a nitpicky, busybody type thing to specify how many frames are in each animation. The only reason you'd want to do that is if you had two different animations that were using the exact same sprite frames, and one was a one length and one was another. And I decided I would never want to do that. So I made it easy on myself and just did percent D for all animations like these. And that just loads however many frames it can find for that animation. And since that all happens before the game actually runs, it's all good. It's a really, really, it's a time saver for sure. So, input, anything else to add to input component? Yeah, flags, we'll get that. Repeat count, repeat max. I have never used that yet, so I'm not going to need to worry about that for now. Okay. Great. We've got this started. Now let's start changing the code as well. So each one of these components is now going to be able to take a Valtry node instead of just taking everything from one single line of a string. So this is going to be way better. Right, so we'll start with health component. Maybe input actually. Let's start with input component. This is a really easy one. All right, so corresponding here is input component.h. Oh, if you've noticed, I restructured my entire project. This is really cool. So I'll do this now. I was gonna save this for maybe for later in the stream, but I think it's a good time to do this. I restructured the whole project according to how Xcode works. So the other day I was really griping about Xcode and its tabs and things like that, but I figured out how to work with Xcode rather than Xcode working against me. The important part about Xcode is to realize how its tabs work. A tab in Xcode is actually an entire workspace. It remembers everything. You can change whether this thing, your sidebar thing is showing. You can change whether that's showing, and it will remember that for each one of these tabs. Another great thing about tabs in Xcode is you can name them, and that I highly recommend doing this. Yeah. So, I highly recommend doing this. When you're in Xcode, you can name your tab, right? So I named this tab source. And then when you're in behaviors, you can set up your behaviors and stuff. And this is the other key part of Xcode, is you've got to learn how to work with its behaviors and its tabs. So for example, when a build fails, Akuma, what's up, man? Yay. Yeah, so when a build fails in Xcode normally, or starts. Actually, starts is a good one to show, because I don't care about when a build starts. So I unchecked everything. So it's not going to change my view or whatever. So this is really important, to get in here and change all these. And then this is the other great part, is if let's say a build generates some issues, I can show the actual tab named build. Before, this was something else. This was like show the something navigator with issues. This was it. Yeah, this was on, right? This is what it did before. But now it shows the tab named build. So I have a special workspace tab called build, just dedicated to builds. And so I can see everything that I would want to see in a build right here. And for example, if the game breaks at a breakpoint, it shows the console tab. And the console tab's all set up for debugging. I don't have to go and stretch my window and change anything. All of this is ready to go. So this is a pretty cool thing. So I keep everything now in a source view. I've got a data view for all my data. I got a console view, build view, and then another project view, which I haven't used as much. But anyways, this has really helped my workflow with Xcode. And then secondly, I restructured the entire project so I don't need this bullshit anymore, this stupid project navigator. This thing is really slow to use. If you're actually gonna use this thing, it's really slow. Like, let's say I'm working on an attack component. I'm like, all right, great. I do some work. And then I'm like, you know what? I need to go and actually work on something in the game. I go all the way, and this is so slow to go click something, open up a different folder, click another file. So slow, bad. So I don't ever use that anymore, and I use these. These are way quicker. And then, in fact, which is even quicker is there's a shortcut where you can quickly open things, and this thing is badass. Yeah. For some, Visual Studio is, of course, going to be way better. In fact, it's great how their tabs work in Visual Studio, and as well as like Lime or Sublime Text and stuff like that. But yeah, so this is just working with Xcode the way it's designed rather than trying to work against it. And this quick open thing is badass. Check this out. Like if I can start this quick open. Let's say I want to open the attack component. All I got to do is type @co. You can type parts of your file names and then easily open up stuff. So I love that command, and I'm using that so much now that I don't even really need these anymore. So anyways, there, show and tell done for the moment. Okay, let's get back to the health component. This thing, when instead of taking a string, it's going to take a val tree. You dislike it because it has the word lime in it? That's funny. I can totally understand that though. There, this is way better. Creating a health component with data. Data. All right, if there's no need to split the words or to do any of this stuff. All right, let's start. Oh no, we got rip again. Oh, false alarm. Oh, you just despite the fact that it has lime in the name. Okay. Yeah, of course, man. Please link away. If it's a YouTube video, I'm probably not going to open it right now, but I will check it out later. It's just that the YouTube has been crashing the stream a lot lately, so I'm not opening as many YouTube videos. So for example, hit points, we would go. HP equals data dot get child. Oh, right, Adam, yeah. Awesome, man. Well, cool. So yeah, I'll check this out later, man. You want to give me like the one sentence or the brief version here in the chat? So we're going to read HP, and this is going to be data to get int. Man, it would be really nice if this valtree method, you could pass in a default value for getInt. Like if this value is 0, it returns the default value instead. I'm gonna do it. Valtree.h. Get key, get string, get int, get float. There. These are now going to be more versatile functions. Yeah, that's what I did there. Thanks, Boogie. Oh, cool. Nice, right on, Akuma. Cool. You know, placeholders are a great way to start. Oh. Because you can get behavior, sometimes it can be much faster to create behaviors and you know, using placeholder art and stuff like that first. And then you can easily go in and do something later on. You know, you can easily add art later. Once you've got behaviors done, though, a lot is finished. Oh yeah, it's definitely Twitch's fault today. We can all blame Twitch. Here we go. So. So valine is equal 0, just return default val. There, more versatile. Yeah, that can, right. Yeah, that's another aspect of that that's important, right? If you make things look good before you make it work well, sometimes it's hard to get it to stay working well you know what I mean? Sorry, I'm having trouble trying to say that. But yeah, that can be a trap that you fall in, right? You've got something looking really good, but it doesn't work well. So what do you do? Do you have to make compromises to get it to work well and look good? You know? What's up, King Nothing? Yeah. Yeah, sometimes, true. Yeah. Oh, this is default value. There. Okay, so I go back to the health component. That's the one I was on, right? Yeah, okay. And then here we can do a get int and the default value. After all that, the default value is still... Oh, parse life. Oh, we need to parse life on this. Parse life and then clamp I. Okay, anyways, this is. Oh, parse life as well. Yeah. Hey, what's up, Teek? Welcome, man. All right, man. Good night. Oh. Well, yeah, dude. Get some good rest, dude. From your point of view, 0 is not identifying that val incorrect. What's that? What are you talking about? Let's make another parse life function here that can take an integer. Or float val. So yeah, we take double val times double klife root container. It's gone again. Yeah, sorry guys. All right, great. So that we'll do something like that, and then invincible duration. This isn't going to be a lot easier. Invincible duration is data get child invincible duration dot get float. And the default value for that is going to be 0.5. Yeah, but it doesn't matter. Yeah, it doesn't matter if zero is a legit value for that. All I'm trying to do is give it a default value, and that's optional, right? So if I parse something and yeah, it's meant to be zero, I'm not going to ever pass it a default value or care there. I only care if something is meant to have a default value like this. If that's zero, or if there's no string value, I guess I could test the string. Yeah. What's up, Spymort? Mm-hmm. And invincible, what's the other one? Blinks. I think this is an integer. Yeah, that's an integer. So the default there is going to be 2. Yeah, testing the string might be better, I guess. Did I really type that as invincible? Wait. This is so great. I've had invincible duration for probably at least a year now in the code. I can't believe that's so funny. Let's fix that. Invincible duration. You have to leave it. Oh man. If only I hadn't already fixed it. All right, and I'm clamping these values as well. This is smart. I should clamp all these. Clamp F. Ooh, I'm hating that. I'm gonna change that behavior right now. It keeps on showing me issues. I don't want it to show me issues. Just don't even show issues. Sometimes I want it to show me issues, but most of the time I don't. Because I'm usually building in the background. There, now we just totally redone that, and that's way better. Invincible is a good name for an enemy. Oh, yeah. You definitely would want to pass, if you have a render component with like a sprite in it, you would want to pass in any kind of parent. So yeah, the scene or a layer or whatever kind of parent you're going to use as like what's going to hold all of your stuff in your scene. So what's the problem? Are you having trouble with actually getting a parent? Is your parent a good sprite? Is that a good pointer value, your get parent? Or is the problem that you're just having problems actually passing it? What were you talking about there? Where is this? You're mentioning this. Sorry, J2. I'm not on the same page. I think you're talking about this. I'm deleting this now. This is no longer needed. This new code is replacing all that stuff. Right? There's no more need for shorthand with this more specific data. So let me just verify that's good. HP equals MAC HP, clamp I, parse life, HP get in. $0.99. This is invincible duration, clamp F, parse float. Default value 0.5, 0.1 to 60. Blinks, clamp I, int, default value 2, 0 to 16. Cool. There we go. Much better. Much better. Okay, yeah. All right, great. And so to match that up with this, the only other thing in there is explosion size, and I know where that is, so I'm going to go specifically to that. Explosion size. Oops. Here in NMs, but it's actually called from health system. Oh, great. We're using get attribute. This is actually pretty cool because I can switch this up. Instead of using get child, I can do query. Spymore, you asking me? My scenes inherit, I think they're from layer actually. Let me check. Game scene. Yeah, game scene actually uses layers. I'm using layers instead of node. Yes, that's true. Scenes do inherit from node. Everything pretty much inherits from node. Yeah, oh yeah, you already said that. So instead of get child, we can use query here. Boom. That's really nice. Because now, back here, I can call get vec2. Instead of that, I can do get vec2 input dot explosion size or health dot explosion size. So now the data can be more clear and readable. This is much more readable data, but now it's underneath a node, so it needs that dot there, but easily can allow that. So once again, we're looking at these. Let's make sure there's nothing else Yeah, that's just get red, gets red once. Okay, cool. All right, I do believe we're done with health component. Now, the other thing we need to do is to get the area creation. I keep opening that when I need to do that. There's this function which creates a being. An auto ref health, instead of getting a string, we're returning a val. Yeah, we're getting a val tree. Much better. Okay, so now health. We can just say, instead of checking its size. So if it's not null, we create a health component with the health val tree data. So awesome. And at this point, it's probably gonna crash. The rest of the code is probably gonna crash, but let's start building and see what happens. RIP again. Oh. Is there anything on my end I can fix? Oh, it says everything's hunky-dory here. Alright, so we got one component, more data-driven. I need to go through and change other components and stuff, but I'm going to keep on working on the data for the boss here. It's back, huh? Back. Back, oh! Unrip. Yeah, I hear you, man. Got assembly homework to do. Okay, next component is input. This is a really easy one. All right, input component it is. Input component. Yeah, you too. See you, Lime. What's up, Red Cho Charity? Red Co Charity. What's up, man? Welcome to the stream. Sorry, the stream is crazy today. There's some problem on, we're thinking it's on Twitch's end. Something's just crazy today. Super crazy. Oh, so the input component isn't even using data. Let me check it all the places where I do new input component. I bet you I'm doing 0, 0 for every one of them. Yep, 0, 0. Okay, yeah, this needs a val tree creation method data. Okay, so if we get created with data, we we'll use the default constructor, 0, 0. And the only thing this thing is really going to parse is, for now, at least, is the allow input. Oh, man. I keep pressing that. These two keys are too close together. Doesn't it? Yeah. I know. My code's not that, like, really organized, but at least it's better than it was. Like this function right here could be a lot better. Both of these, create being. All right, so attach or input. This is gonna work like this now. It's just gonna grab the input data component. So if we have the input data, then we create this. Much simpler. This is going to be such a cool reusable method. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. So we'll just say flag. This thing already has flags. So, oh, this we need to use this getDirs method, though. Profile.getDirs. Oh, look, it already knew where to go with that. That's great. So we get the string, and then we parse flags with the, oh, okay. This is easy. Data. Get string, or get child. Allow, get string, parse that. That's it. Oh, man, I love how code, when you simplify code and you do things the right way, things get so much shorter. Shorter code, easier to maintain, easier to read. All we need is just get parse flags. It doesn't matter if this is an empty string. We'll have zero flags come back. If this does have any good words in this allow, we're good. This is a simple, fully functional statement right there. Okay, so back to area creation. And there's no more need to manually set these flags because we've already passed in the inputs data right there. Okay, next thing on the list, we've got input done, health done, next thing, collision. So collision component. Instead of passing in this string, pass in valtree data. And we can say category equals collision component parse mask. On data.getChild. Category.getString. And once again, this is a perfectly safe statement here because all we're doing is parsing it. If it ends up being an empty string, we're going to get zero back as the category, and that's okay. It's not what we would desire for something, but zero for a category is better than, you know, some other random value. Okay, so yeah, category, good. Mask is almost the exact same thing, but mask. Size, I'm using parse vector. Let's get all these out. Oh, category actually is a default. Does have a default value. So, actually, no. You know what? I'm gonna get rid of that default value for category. It's not how it should work. It should be specific. It should be zero or the data has a good value. So that's how it should be. So these default values here. Flow, all these shots, the damage, size, all of those. There's no more need for these default values. They can be specified easily in the data. And if they're not, that's just lazy data, which is easy to fix. Mask is parse mask. Size, damage, flags. Oh, size is a V3F now. That's right. Size, we can just call size.set. Passing in a string. Data get child for collision component size. I believe that's all it needs. Yeah, size. And that could even have a third dimension to that if needed. Next up, damage. Damage is clamp by from 0 to 99. Parse life. Yeah. Data get child. Damage. Get float. Flags is also really nice and easy to parse. Flags like a string. All right, cool. How are we doing? Did the stream just die? Okay, now parsing out the damage. Oh yeah, damage for these is okay. All right, so the next thing to do would be hook it up an area component, area creation. It's still up, okay, all right. Amazing, it's amazing. Yeah, okay, so we're just gonna grab profile, get attribute, collision. Check any other references for collision. Oh, that's good. All right. Yeah, so we just need to check if it was null, and if not, create a collision component. Easy enough. Okay. That should be good to go for that. Health component, I do want to fix up health component now that I've decided all values should be default to zero. I don't even need to pass in this whole get float 0.5 for invincible duration. I don't need to pass 2 for invincible blinks. In fact, I could probably just take out those default values from val tree, but yeah. Let's take it out. That wasn't exactly the, I don't know. I guess it was kind of confusing that these methods. No, you know what? I'll just keep these. Change of mind. Those might be useful in the future. Okay. Collision, we got health, input. Next thing, move. Changing it so it also takes a val tree data instead of a cryptic string. We're using a nice val tree data structure. Going to this guy's component. All right, so mask, of course, it's an easy one. Data get child, mask get string. Speed, parse vector, yeah, that's also gonna be a string. Acceleration. This one is actually just a float. Get float. Deceleration, same thing. All right, great. No default values. We're parsing the mask, parsing speed. Parsing acceleration, parsing deceleration. Oh, this is awesome. This is so great to just get rid of these. Get rid of code. I love getting rid of code. And what's great about this too is later on, I can easily go and add values to this valid. Like if I want to go and like add the ability to parse flags, I can easily do that. Or a speed factor, or whatever. Okay, now move component. Let's get it hooked up in area creation. And that's it. And I'm going to take a quick little break. I'll be right back. Back to it. Right. Yeah, there's something crazy going on. Well, I'm just going to keep streaming because in case this is working for anyone or it does come in at just the right moment, you catch something awesome, something like that. Okay. The next thing to convert is a move component. Already did move component. Never mind. It just did move component. Cool. Attack then. This might be the last one too. Attack component. Passing in. Valtry. Attack component. This one has just a ton of defaults. This should be just like this one. It should take all its defaults by using the default constructor, of course. 0000. And then, yeah, so then instead of calling parse, it doesn't need parse anymore. All right, attack component was kind of set up specially for that. We're not going to need parse anymore. Alright, so this taking all these values, parsing them from data. It's the first word, or was the first word, get child. What's it now? Mask. Mask. Parse mask. Yes. Damage. That's one thing. Dot damage. This is now positive. F.collision.damage. This should be able to be positive or negative. Let's make this smart. Negative abs. There. So no matter what, that'll work. Okay. Yeah, it really doesn't matter whether that's like any of those values for dot damage or negative or positive. Cool. Back to here we go. Attack component. That's right. Attack component. So damage is going to be parse life based on damage and get float. Delay time. That should probably be clamped to some reasonable values, just in case. So delay time, or how long does the attack opponent delay before the attack hitbox appears? Minimum 0, maximum, you know, like 99 seconds is forever. So that'd be way too much time. In fact, 9 seconds is even probably too far. Right. What error message do you have right now? And the same kind of thing for duration. This is very similar. Duration, clamp-f, duration. Okay, so the duration of the whole, this attack box, yeah, this is a similar thing. If this lasted longer than 9 seconds, it would be, like, way too long. Okay. Attack box h. This, we're going to parse an actual string. What? Did the stream completely die now? Oh, it says it's not. It says it's not here. Dude, when it comes to the STL and C++, it's all templated, so that's why there's so much. Alright, so this is going to be shake duration, get float, shake duration, the amount of, how long this should shake the screen. I could see it possibly being more than 9 seconds for a shake. Same thing with the strength, though, 0 to 9 for shake strength. Now we're not gonna need, whoa, there's two types of parse, that's right. There's oh yeah, shot. It's just shot. Okay. So let me get the type of this attack component. Get child type, get string. If type, type is melee, Type is shot. Shot is that type. Oh, wait, no. We need a special word for shot. Call it spawn. So we're going to spawn something. Type is shot. Shot name? Entity name? I'm trying to think of better words for this. Yeah, spawn is actually a pretty good word for that. Okay. So now we've got a melee component parsed out. I'm not using default values anymore. Oh, but I will need this to reference. For stuff with other attack components. Wow, it's a crazy quiet stream today with the Twitch all broken. It's kind of interesting. I feel like I'm just talking to myself, coding. Which is hard, by the way. It's hard to talk in code. It's not very comfortable or natural. Tile sync offset. That is something needs to be fixed. Tile sync offset. Yeah, attack system, e profile, get vec2. This is now going to be attack dot tile sync offset. Easy enough. All right, now we don't need this node anymore. I do believe. What do I want to talk about? I don't know. Games, physics, the future of technology, you know, the huge. All right, now we just can get the attack component right there. Attack. If not, is null. Make sure there's no other, yeah, great. There's no other places that are using that. So get bool, this thing also should be able to use queries. Yeah, technology, right? Technology is awesome. Like Bucky paper. Where's the Bucky paper, man? No Bucky paper? What's up with the no Bucky paper? I want Bucky paper right now, man. I want my whole car to be made out of Bucky paper. Pathfind. Oh, what is pathfind? Move. That's move.pathfind. Oh, and this pathfind? This should be part of move. Sounds like synthetic spiderwebs. That's a thing too. There's another company that's making synthetic spiderwebs. They're learning how to make material out of spiderweb-y stuff. It's some company in, I think like in Arizona or Nevada or something. Technology's great, man. Where are we going with everything? Why not win? Cool. Good for you, man. Yay. I'm excited for you. All right, pathfind and area boundary should be move flags. So I've got this pathfind 0, but really it should be flags, nothing. Cool, man. Nice. Have fun with that. I'd love to see a screenshot when you make one. All right, this means we're gonna need a couple more things. The move component. Oh. Dude, I gotta get rid of this command zero thing. This command zero command is horrible. Key bindings. Right on. Yeah, cool, man. It sounds like you're really excited about it. And what's great about that is excitement is the key. It's the key to making games, man. When you're excited about stuff, it's like things are twice as easy. They get done twice as fast. They're twice as good, you know? Excitement is really, really important. And that's why I'm always saying follow your heart. Follow your excitement. Follow those things that excite you, because your heart will lead you to amazing things in this whole game development world. It's like show navigator. What the hell? What command am I looking for? View. View. Navigators. There. View navigators. View. Navigators, show navigator, get rid of this command. This thing is horrible. Keep accidentally pressing it. You're always making me laugh, man. C++. I know what you mean, though, man. For a while, I was using other stuff besides C++, and I came back to it. And at first, I was like, man, C++ again. But now I like it. I'm really loving it. But I am looking forward to what Jonathan Blow is creating with his language, and because I might be using that in the future. Hyrule Spy. What's up, Hyrule Spy? I hope the stream is okay for you today. Twitch is really, really crazy today. The stream's probably going to go in and out on you if you're watching. Songbird's coming along really well, man. There's an Indie Cup tournament coming, or not a tournament, but like a competition for indie games coming up on December 10th in San Francisco, and Songbringer's going to be one of the games, and really, really excited for it. I'm trying to make the game a little more fun. I've got a better video. In fact, I'll play the video right now. Here, I'll play this video for you. This is the new video. I wanted to get some thoughts on it, so here we go. I think the sound's okay. Yeah, you guys should have sound.
Oh.
Sorry, the color's all messed up. There we go. So it's just a shorter version. Some press quotes at the beginning. I think it's better. Right on. The stream isn't frozen because I... Oh, really? It froze right there? Well, anyways, the video will be up tomorrow. If anybody did happen to see that... Okay, cool. Some boogie saw it. But yeah, if they... Yeah, any thoughts... If anybody has any thoughts on that, please let me know, because I got a few hours left. I can try and do another draft of that, but pretty much it's almost done. The color was messing up because Flux is running right now, and Flux is doing his thing. So let's turn off Flux there. Now my colors are back to normal. You didn't see it at all? Oh, you didn't even see it. Oh, well. Well, it'll be out. It'll be out on YouTube later. Okay, so back to parsing flags. These two things, move component, will par. So no one saw it. Oh, okay. I'll try it again. I'll try it one more time. Let's hope it doesn't freeze again, because it's because of Twitch. But yeah, I'll try it one more time. That time. It just froze again? Oh, damn. Well, it might have been because I made it full screen, but oh well. You'll see it later. I'm pretty sure it's a good video. It's the best I can do right now. Later on, when I got some better content, you know, from the game, it'll help. So we need some constants for K move. Pathfinding area boundary, no auto stop. All right. So we'll need some more words of dictionary we can parse called K move. We'll call them K move flags, so it's really nice and specific. And then in constants.cpp, we'll just have two words. It's a really easy to parse dictionary, just ready to go for parsing out move components. So K move flags. We've got pathfinding. Right on. Bakfu. Pathfind, area boundary. There, those are the only two words we need parsed for now. And the move component itself just parses flags. What is that? Bakfu? Bakfu is the awesomest thing ever. Data get child flags dot get string using the words k move flags. There. So now we can parse out pathfind. Oh, you know what? I should probably do pathfind as well as pathfinding. Either one of these words will work. Let's make sure that's right. So kit parse flags, data get child flags, string, move flags. Yeah, this should parse correctly. Should. Ah, what a dangerous word. Okay, but anyways, so this would be like, instead of pathfind, this would be flags. Just empty. Oh, area boundary though. Area boundary is something that almost every entity is going to use. I almost wish this would be instead of area boundary. Pathfind, no, not needed. Area boundary, not needed. Oh, pathfind is the only thing that defaults true. Okay. Oh, that's right, because because most entities get that added later on. What's up, professional novice? Yo! Welcome to the stream. Sorry if the stream is really bad and glitchy today. There's some issue going on. I'm not sure what's up. All right, other components, additive. This should be, instead of additive, there should be a render. Oh yeah, yeah, you've already been experiencing it then. Well, man, thanks for battling past the reconnecting to say hi, man. Appreciate it, hope you're doing well. I think it would just be like render, additive, reflection. Shadow. Yeah, so shadow defaults to true. Reflection defaults to true. Additive should be zero. Default. Yeah. Oh, Songbird's going great, man. Yeah, just getting really excited for the Indy Cup coming up December 10th. Other than that, I'm doing a lot of data-driven stuff today. I'm just making things better and better and better because at this point, Songbird's about halfway finished, I'm thinking. It's probably going to be a whole nother year of development. And at this point, I'm not sure how I'm going to get the funds to do that year, but yeah. But anyways, I've got faith, man. I know something good's going to happen. And if not, you know, I can try and push the game out a little bit early and just keep doing, maybe like do sort of like an early access plan or something like that. I don't know. But yeah, I prefer to just release it in, you know, as late as possible. So it's just it's really awesome. Shadow, reflection. All right, we need render. So render.getChild, shadow.getInt. This is also passing in shadow y. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I am, man. I'm committed to risking it all at this point. I mean, it's exciting. You know, it's very exciting to see how this is unfolding. Like, had I never risked it, I never would have done the Kickstarter and realized how awesome Kickstarters can be, you know? So it's good to risk. It's very good to take risks. And I believe that, you know, fortune does favor the bold. So if I invest in Bitcoin. Right, and then we could also do shadow. No, yeah, shadow should be its own thing. Reflection should be its own thing. These are different components. So shadow, this should be offset y. And reflection should be its own. Reflection. For now, that's just one whole component like that. Oh, nice. Yeah. Thanks, man. I appreciate you saying that. I believe it too. I believe it, man. It's tough to, it's great to get that kind of outside, you know, perspective, because when you're being that person, when you're the dev or whatever that's doing this, you know, you don't know. You don't know whether your stuff's going to be successful or if it is currently being successful in its own way. So it's nice to, thank you, man. Thanks for sharing your perspective. Okay, so shadow and render are now their own components as well. or shadow and reflection. So if not shadow dot is null, then we can create this, and the shadow offset y is going to be shadow dot get child offset y get int, or yeah, get int. Now, same thing with reflection. If reflection is not null, thanks, guys. And oh, additive. Instead of additive, I was just thinking this could possibly be rewritten in a totally different way, but I'll save that second sort of refactor for later. Simplifying these components would be even better, like render having even more, you know, data points, basically. So this would be render get child additive get int. Oh, and flash is another thing. So we'll get the flash float. Flash greater than zero, create a flash, right? And we don't need it up here. We don't need like grab it twice. We don't need any of these things. Shadow is now good. Reflection. Yeah, that's good. What's up, Gatsby? I'm programming a game called Songbringer right now. Thanks, Boogie. You can't even make a pillow right now? Oh, in 3D? Pillows are kind of hard to make in 3D. You should try making like a more square pillow. Or like a, you know? Pillows are hard, especially the buttons. It's tricky stuff to do in 3D. All right, good. Collide when dead. This whole flag is just a weird one, but. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Scope small, man. Scope small. If you do want to make a game, just make it the smallest game you possibly can, you know, and then instead of taking 2 years, it'll take 2 months. Oh, yeah. That must have been funny. All right, input. Yeah, we did input. Skins, dialogue. All right, for now, this is enough. This is good. Should be able to build now. Let's get a build going, and I need to start doing all the rest of the data. So I need to convert everybody else's profiles and start using this kind of format. All right, this guy is a boss. Actually, I'm not sure if I need the boss anymore. Right? Do you have the iPad Pro? If you do, how do you like it? Dude, what's up? I guess because it probably just was building. Oh yeah, it's just building. Oh yeah, those things are kind of expensive, huh? Render. Let's do one, reflection one, shadow one. This guy's input component is allow, I think just 8. Yeah. Yeah, it probably did. Which is, and I don't think it's on my end. But I don't know, I could be wrong. This could just be my fault. It could be my computer today, but. All right, I think input components. Yeah, I can do 4 or 8. So for the blob boss, he can move in all directions. We'll say just input allow 8. Much funner. All right, so this guy has a health of 20, which is really weak, actually. Invincible duration 0.5, blinks 2, explosion size. When he's done, when he's ready to explode, he turns into 5540. There, health component's done. Collision component has a size of 50 by 36. Category foe, shot friend, damage, flags. And the move component. This guy moves 75, 75. I think these accel durations and decel durations are okay. There's no need for any move flags. Wait a second. Move flags. What was the default again? Oh, man. Area boundary was defaulted to false. Pathfinding to true, though. Okay. So move flags, default, pathfind. Yeah, nice, 1-0 win. Yay. This guy has no attack opponent, that's easy. Okay, I'm getting kinda itchy. I wanna try this out. Let's start with the drop boss, this first guy. And make sure he parses correctly and all that. So I can check out the console. Let's run the game, first of all. Okay, flies. Flies is they're messed up. Let's get the flies working. Shadow zero. We don't need to do that anymore. Move. Let's grab a move component. This is a neutral entity, though. Yeah, all this thing has is a move component. So it has no mask. That's easy. Speed 60-60. Speed up, slow down 0.3. Flags, pathfind, nothing. Area boundary 1. So all it has is an area boundary flag. All right, let's see if the flies work now. Nope. Some problem with targeting the nearest friend or foe. Okay. Way to do this would be to set a breakpoint there. In the behavior, so that would be AI system. Target. There it is. All right, so we got a breakpoint there. We'll figure out why these flies are messing up now. Probably something to do with all these, of course, this change. It's a huge refactor, kind of. Okay, so we're targeting nearest. What's the stir vowel one? Oh, subtype 124, that should be nearest. Nice, right on. Serval zero, Serval one, friend foe, yeah. Potential sorted. Oh, this guy already has a target mask. What is your target mask, my friend? E, AI, target mask, 96. Hopefully that's friend and foe. Probably is. Right on. Good for you, dude. That's a really good practice to have, man. Making all your own textures, even your own sounds. That can be really, you can create a really unique feel for your game that way. So good on you, man. Okay, this should be getting some yids. We're in this method now. We've got an acceptable yid. We've got a good vector. We've got a good mask. Oh, I guess what could be going on here is that nothing has any masks or nothing has any categories. So what did this return? Potential size zero. Yeah, that's the problem. There's absolutely nothing to target. Okay, so this has to have something to do with collision categories. First thing to check here is this collision, this parsing of the collision entities. All right, collision, yeah, collision. Oh, what's this? This is an old guy. Something. Oh, yeah. Well, of course, we at least need to go and make sure that Rock and Jib have theirs working. Ooh, this is dangerous. That is the wrong file to be using. Okay, we need to get rid of something here. I got this set up where it imports this assets folder. So I've got two ways to access the same data, which is wrong, which is bad. Very bad. So we should just throw sounds and shader and textures down here. Just remove the reference for that folder. Let's put in a new reference for these other folders. Sounds, folder reference, and textures. Okay, so now when I do the same thing, when I go quick open rock.txt. Yeah, there's only one instance of it. So I'm editing the right file now. Much, much better. Shadow, looks like shadow, just regular. Input, allow eight, all eight directions. Health component, we have, it's like one hit point. Or three, let's put it at three. But yeah, this gets, actually yeah, one's better because that gets set. Oh hell, even zero would be better than that. Because that gets set by the game. So invincible duration is 1.0. It's a whole second, he's invincible, wow. Forgot about some of these things. Cool, we've got a health component now. That's done. Dialogue, we'll get that. Collision. Nice, right on. Collision category for Rock is friend. Mask is foe. Size 12-6. Damage 0. Flags. No flags. Yeah. Whoops. High five. Attack type melee, attack mask, foe container switch, damage 1.0, nice. Build succeeded, isn't that a great feeling? Delay, duration. Size. All right, next move flags. So here's all the things he collides with. Speed he moves at. Top speed. Accel. Decel. Flags. He has pathfinding and area boundary. There we go. He's been converted. Convert or die. Yeah. It's, you know, it's kind of a DIY style game engine. Okay, now that we've got one hero, hopefully that target works for the flies now. Oh yeah. Oh, so the Roz enemy, of course, is going to be all messed up. Yeah, Roz mini boss messed up. But we've gotten a lot farther. So the next thing Oh, let me see. Did I set another breakpoint? I don't need that breakpoint. Okay, so next let's do the Roz mini boss. Yes. Well, this is really good to see this like that. All this data, much more readable. Pretty awesome. This guy can move in all eight directions. He has 16 hit points, or 16 whole hearts, or life, or whatever. Invincible. Explosion size. Category foe. Collision 22-19. Default collision mask. Default collision damage. No collision flags. Move. This should be all the same. And this excel duration is really important to this character. This boss is the whole character of this boss comes down to like this one line right here, making him accelerate slowly, makes him really interesting to fight. Move flags. It looks like this guy has. Yeah, it's this guy can pathfind. No attack opponent. This guy just attacks by moving. And that's it. Sweet. I'll check these out. These might be a good thing to recommend. I never finished college either. Right? You know, I mean, I went to college but never finished. So, I could finish on my own! The University of the Internet! Okay, can we... does this work? Yeah, look at that! It looks like the flies are broken though. I see there's a couple flies on the screen and they're just moving. They're not even moving. I'm going to YouTube you. Where are you going? All right. Well, yeah, that's it. That's going to be it for today's stream. I'm over 2 hours here on the stream, and it's been a definitely glitchy, twitchy day. So, but the good news is that this new data-driven format for making components of entities loaded from data is going to be awesome. I'm glad it's already working. The game's like, you know, already working this way. So I'm going to continue on with this tonight and finish up this and also publish this video and stuff like that. So yeah, that's it for today's stream. And thank you guys. The pushback dust? Oh no, that's been there. Yeah, the pushback dust has been there for a while. Probably just wasn't noticeable because it's the same color as the dirt. But yeah, thanks for watching, everybody. Have a good night. We'll be back tomorrow.